Welcome to Humanity's Heart. My name is Dr. Robyn Mills, and I'm here today with Bill McKenna. He's pioneered a groundbreaking method for creating massive change, shifting perspectives, and raising consciousness. And I, for one, have just experienced it, and it was a wonderful experience. Hello, Bill.
Hi. Thank you for having me on.
It's just wonderful. And we've had a long chat prior to coming on, and I really felt immersed in it. I can't wait for people to get an understanding of what you've created. Would you like to tell us about it?
Sure. Well, there's multiple aspects to it. Now, I'll tell you the first aspect of this is around manifestation. And it was a beautiful thing because you got to experience it.
I did.
Now, Cognomovement and Cognoquantum, the things we've developed, we basically have come to some new understandings of the way things manifest. So everybody's already familiar with the law of attraction. I don't need to review that. But what people aren't familiar with is, and now you are, because you got it became real for you, is that when things go from a thought to a material object, everybody knows that that's the case, right? We think about it and then it becomes material. What a lot of people don't realize is that this exists right in the field around you, but you can physically reach out and touch it with your hand, and you got to experience it. Like, and you're not not special in that way. It's just you can literally touch it.
I am special, but yes.
But you like
it was great. It was great, yes.
So it's a physical, you can physically reach out and touch it, although it hasn't become material yet, but you can actually feel it. And the other thing that we had realized is that you, me, we are transformers, meaning your energy system goes from very high frequency, ideas and thoughts, down to a very low density, which is the material manifestation. And your energy centers in your body go through a downgrading process, slower and slower frequency. We've discovered that you can actually pull it out of the field, into the body, and down to the point where it can manifest. We're speeding the process up. And it works in perfect conjunction with the law of attraction. In the law of attraction, we're taught you got to feel it as if it's real. Well, we're all in the process of sitting there like, yes, I'm good with it. It's real. Well, you know what? The Ferrari didn't show up. It's not in the driveway. And I kind of think about real. But when you go through this process, interestingly enough, like for you, right? We did a thing.
It was great.
And you, it's not like you don't, like you're trying to say, I feel confident that this is happening. You just do.
Yes, right? You just know. Yes. Bill, there's something happening with your sound. I don't know if it's your elbows hitting the desk or when you become animated, the sound sounds a bit like a drum, like you're tapping something on the desk or something's making a drumming noise. Yeah.
I'll try to turn down my gain just a little bit there.
Okay. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Yes. And it really felt great because it's not something I've experienced before, but I feel like I just healed a lifetime worth of drama, you know, in an instant, and it just feels clear and free. It's a wonderful process. What else can you tell people about it?
Well, when you or me are in the process of manifesting something, when we feel really secure about it is when we can let go, right? It's in the when we don't feel secure, and that means it's not in my base chakra or base of my physical body, and that part feels it without any fear, right? Then the opportunity for it to manifest quickly exists. So what this is a speeding up of the process, and it is a natural thing that follows the natural flow. When we are trying to manifest something out there, we think about it, we feel it, and then it shows up in the field that's right around us. Now, this is out in the field, and anything in our field is not here and now. It's outside of us. It either is before or after this time frame. Right here and now is right in the center line of your body. So we're just facilitating the process of moving it into here and now. One of those things, and you got to experience it, maybe you can tell people about your experience, but not only the thing we want to manifest is in the field, but in addition to that, the things that are in conflict with it. So we can reach out and touch and feel those, and then we can clap them right out of your field, and all of a sudden, you don't feel it anymore, right? I mean, when we went, go ahead, you can tell them your story.
Yes, so when we were looking at manifesting a house that I'm about to start building, there were financial blocks. There were blocks within me and ones that I knew about, but also ones that I thought I'd well let go of. And so when I could actually physically feel them as an energy ball within my hands in my auric field, the clapping just dissolved them. It was a really lovely feeling. And then when I took that down into my root chakra, I think you called it the base chakra, it had a sense of bringing it home. Like, oh, it's back home now. It's a really beautiful, peaceful feeling. It's not a rah, rah, rah on there. It's just like a, oh, I'm home. It's peaceful. It's gentle. Yeah.
Like it's as if you have it.
I have it already. It's a beautiful house.
Already, and you're not struggling or trying to pretend that you have it. It's like that's just how it feels.
Yeah, and it feels like I deserve it, and it's going to be beautiful. And it's quite a really beautiful shift. Any doubt or worry just seems to have disappeared, and I'm really excited about that. Coming in. So even though you, I guess that what that shows me is even though you choose to have things in your life, there's often doubts, worries, you know, part of your history that will fight the manifesting of that. And what you did this morning was help me let go of any of those barriers that were preventing the ease and grace of it coming into my life.
Correct. Oh, I'm so happy. I'm happy that we met and we got to It's that's really fun.
You know, I know that you showed me some slides earlier when you were explaining the process to me. I wonder if I gave you access, if you'd be able to run us through those.
I'd be happy to. So you just tell me when you're ready for me to share.
You're in charge.
Okay, here we go. Let's see. Let's see if we can do this here. Try the technical. Well, actually, this is going to be a two-step process. Bear with me 2 seconds, and I will, I'm almost there with you.
That's okay. I can certainly talk until then.
Okay.
Share so,
screen, and here we go. Okay. All right. So what I had developed is something called Cognomovement. Now, I went through with you the manifesting process, but it does much, much more than just manifesting. What I have discovered is that it will process issues. Like, for example, if you have somebody that you have a big problem with, like your ex-husband, your ex-wife, your boss that fired you, a bankruptcy, some big problem. What we can do is create an emotional amnesia. And we do that through forcing your brain into left-right coherence. So we have this ball, and this ball has colors and symbols on it. And the ball basically occupies the right side of the brain. The left side of the brain is occupied with colors and symbols. And we move this ball in a particular pattern, which forces neurologically your eyes from the three ways that you learn. Low, down here, is your kinesthetic or feelings. Here, level, is auditory function. And up here is your visual. So we are going across from stress is the left brain to creative side, the right brain, and we're going to the different ways that you learn, plus so much more, where we utilize your meridians and different things to produce an emotional amnesia, or like Robyn, we're gonna get you the balls and we're gonna do craving amnesia, so she doesn't have the chocolate anymore. I can't wait to do that with you. I'm sending you the balls.
That would be amazing if chocolate didn't have control of me and I just chose not to eat it all the time. That would be amazing.
It'll there's a bunch of videos on YouTube. If you typed in Cognomovement experience or Cognomovement Coca-Cola, Cognomovement salty foods.
Yeah.
So what happens is the beautiful thing about it is you just imagine that you're enjoying the chocolate. It's the best because you imagine it's the best chocolate of your life, and you do this movement and you're occupying the brain. And what happens typically in about 15 minutes, you're going to have a sensation in your body, and this sensation moves and the craving goes from like a 10 to a zero, and it's permanent. You're not fighting it.
Yeah.
You just don't feel that way anymore. So anyway, I wanted to show you this. This is what's called a biowell. Some of you might be familiar with it. There's a reading right there. This device, you stick your finger in it. Now, it utilizes, there's a professor of photonics at St. Petersburg, Russia, Dr. Konstantin Kronikov, and he basically combined Karelian photography with Korean fingertip acupuncture. So the Koreans for, thousands of years have known, that every different part of your finger represents a different meridian in your body. So here's an example. This is a real life one right here, an image. This is a fingertip of your right thumb. So position number one here on the right thumb is your right eye. And then number two is your right ear, your nose, and maxillary sinus. So how much energy or lack of energy in that area and other factors that they figured out can reflect the entire body in all your fingertips. What he did here, if you see, this is a real life scenario. This woman right here, 80 something years old, had fallen down and busted her right hip. So if you look right here, this is where the busting happened. And amazingly, there was limited energy right here. Well, she, during the process, she had a caretaker who was related to her that, took out her childhood feelings on the mother, and during her vulnerability. This was not a little break. This was, spun, right? So
a spiral fracture.
Yeah, and the leg was that, toast. Yeah. So it had rods and pins and yada yada. So anyway, the amazing thing here is that the woman, she was deathly, this is years later, by the way, deathly afraid of falling. And the reason was, is because of the abuse after. It wasn't like she was afraid of the fall. She was afraid of the caretaker. So we're going to have you just feel the fear. And we did Cognomovment exercise with her feeling the fear. And the emotion felt leave her body and she was free of it. But here's the cool thing. Look at what happened to her energy. Here's the before.
Yeah.
Here's the after.
Oh, that's amazing. Yeah.
Yeah. So before, yeah. After. That's 15 minutes. So, so all that agitation and fear left and the energy returned and filled in. Here's another one. There was another one here. And this one right here was a one that a woman suffered a horrible betrayal. Now, we knew that when we were doing Cognomovement, people are having sensations in their body, and we knew it was the energy centers, but we didn't have a way to measure it. And then when BioWell came, we were able to measure it, and everywhere this woman, she went from a level 10 to a zero, everywhere that she really felt it, then there was actual response right in the body. You can see the shadows. She felt, like heat here, pain here. And then she started choking. This was her throat right over here. You can see moved away. Yeah. Over. So these are just a couple examples, but it's nice to have some physical validation of what's happening to somebody emotionally.
Yes.
And we now have that. We also have some amazing brain scans that we've contracted with a laboratory to do brain scans so that people can see the brain performance. Remarkable mental acuity. And that's how everything happens. It's just forcing your brain to operate more efficiently. And move out these feelings.
And what I love about it is it's a gentleness. Like, firstly, the slides really show us that you can actually have a visual proof if you need it. You may not need it because you're going to feel so good that you may not need the proof, but the fact that it's there, which really validates that part of the brain that likes to have truth. But it's not, in my example, it wasn't a process that you had to, break down and feel destroyed as some processes might, but just gentle, quick, and easy. That's what I loved about it.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Gentle, quick, and easy. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was wondering how it's changed your life.
Oh, woo. Yeah. So, it has changed so much because even though I had kind of gone through a lot of stuff before this, there were things that, I could not really process, thoughts and feelings that were repetitive, that just come up and you get up in the morning and you can't help how you feel, right?
Right.
Feel, right? So, one of the things that changed my life is through a better understanding, and then it became a reality. So the better understanding is that our subconscious, it rules 95% of our lives. Everybody knows this already, right? Well, what I didn't know is that the subconscious expresses itself through the physical body.
Ah, yes.
And so I get a feeling that is my subconscious expressing itself. I don't like that person. I like that person. I like chicken. I don't like that. It's expressing itself as a feeling. Now, when I get a feeling, what happens is it takes a little while. Usually it's instantaneous. And that is that I get a feeling, and then I have a I say, oh, I have this feeling because of this, yeah. this. And so it creates a thought. So I had thought and feeling, right? It loops.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So usually this happens very fast, but some of us get up in the morning and then we're like, why do I feel this way? And you start searching. And then you figure out, oh, it's because of blah, blah, you know, and then you attach to it and it keeps looping.
Yeah.
So the feeling, right, is stuck in our body. And for me, right, the exiting the feeling, the experience of when the feeling goes out of the body and it literally you feel it leave, it will, what'll happen is the thought stops. If I don't feel it, I won't think it. So things, for example, you know, we're all taught, you know, you got to forgive, you know, you go to church and there's like, and he said to forgive, you know, and you're like, well, I know he said do that. I'm human. I can't really do that, you know, for that. You don't understand what happened to me. Who would be the easiest person in the world to forgive? It's the person that you don't feel anything about. Right? Yeah. So you're free. You become free to go where you want. You know, the restaurant you couldn't go to because Dala was there and you're afraid to run into the neighbor or the ex-boyfriend or girlfriend. Imagine you're free. You're just like, ah, whatever. Hey, how you doing?
Right. So that's great.
Yes, it frees us up to come closer to love.
Yep. So I think the question that I asked you was how it affected your life.
Ah, so I find on a daily basis what the actual real effects, real life effects are that what I think about happens. And, you know, I know the process, right, that I walked you through.
Yeah.
But because I am absent, or if I'm absent resentment, or if they do come up, I have a method of relieving myself of the anger. Because of that, what I think about happens pretty quickly. And I'll give you an example. And this is gonna sound like kind of crazy, but it just happened last week. So this will make sense. So here's what happened.
I'm sorry, Bill, can you just move your chair back? I think something's still knocking the sound. If you just move your chair or something so it's not touching the desk, something.
Okay.
Thanks. Thank you.
Sorry about that. I did move my chair. I think the microphone picked it up.
I think it's been picking it up all along. Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry about that, everybody.
That's okay.
Bear with me. All right. So a little story about how it affected me in real terms just last week. Yeah, I'm going to show you where I live. This is where I live.
Oh my God, that's so beautiful.
But outside the front gate, there is a bicycle path right there. You're going to see people probably go by.
Right.
And so a week ago, we had a windstorm. And you can see the sand. The sand blew all the sand up onto the sidewalk.
Yeah.
And I come walking down the boardwalk and I'm like, you know what? I need to clean up the sidewalk. I got to get a shovel because there was this much sand. It was, you know, so I needed a shovel. You know, I was like, I got a shovel and a broom and I need to go and get this cleaned up. And I was like, you know, I'm going to do that maybe about an hour and a half or so because I got some other emails and stuff to get back.
Yeah.
I'm here and all of a sudden I see out of the corner of my eye a homeless person. And I'm kind of like, well, I know it kind of, I can feel it, you know, there's something going on. So I look over and there's a homeless person with a broom.
Wow.
Yeah. Sweeping. Mind you, this walkway goes on for 20 miles. And, you know, and here he is cleaning up in front of my house. And I've lived here for 25 years. Not one neighbor or no homeless people have ever swept my yeah. front in 25 years.
Yes.
And so I go out, I go outside and I say, hi. And he said, hi. I said, hey, thank you for doing that. And I said, what's your name? He says, my name's Bill, Billy. And I said, your name's Billy? That's curious. You know, they used to call me Billy when I was a kid. They call me Bill. He said, oh, nice to meet you, Bill. Cleaning my sidewalk. So anyway, it was, had a nice conversation with Billy, and he cleaned my sidewalk. I gave him a bunch of food and stuff. And anyway, but it was about an hour and a half later, and Bill needed to clean the sidewalk.
Amazing. That's amazing.
But it's like that. So when you ask me, how did it change things? It changed everything.
Yeah.
Right? It's gone from struggle to I don't have the aggravations of life,
yeah,
and things happen quickly and easily. Yeah. That's about the best I can describe.
That's a fantastic way to describe it. And it sounds like ease and grace. And to have a tool, you know, to have a tool at your fingertips, which is what we just looked at, fingertips, a tool at your fingertips that you can go to when those emotions that are interfering with the way you want to become. I think it's fantastic.
Yeah.
Bill, what would be your proudest moment?
My proudest moment? Gosh, you know, that's something I really, you know, it's going to make me think. My proudest moment. There's a lot of things that had happened in, you know, over my life, and I'm not very, like, pride has never been a big thing for me. It's just, I can tell you what makes me feel good.
Yeah.
You know, that's probably more resonates with me.
Yes, go for it.
Is helping people. Mm-hmm. So people come to me and they have, like, there's no way I can possibly get over this, yeah, you know, and the stories, when yeah, if you listen to them, you're like, yeah, you know. So the joy, I would call it bringing me joy by helping somebody that is stuck.
Yeah.
You know, that somebody that's stuck. And then all of a sudden, it's like a whole new world is open to them because they become free. That gives me so much happiness. I will do it 8 hours a day. And people will tell me, say, oh my God, you've been gone for 8 hours and you know, working with one after, you must be exhausted. I said, no. I'm like, I'm excited. I'm ready. Let's go to dinner. This is, you know, I feel great. You know, I could do it. I could do it all day, every day. I love it.
That joy of helping people. I think when you pour love into someone else's heart, it just expands your own heart, doesn't it, really?
Yeah.
It does. So, Bill, if you were towards the end of your life and you looked back, how would your heart say you lived your life?
Oh, that was a good one. Well, you know, the story starts off, shall we say, a little rough. So when I was young, and this was all part of the process, I needed to have the experience of, you know, abuse you know, physical, emotional abuse and, you know, really getting violated in order to understand and to be able to help people. I mean, if somebody ain't been there, right, and felt it, done it, got over it, how can they ever help somebody else? They don't understand, right? You don't understand what they're going through. So I got to experience what it was like to shut down, and I got to experience the awakening and the open up. So if I was to say, what would my heart say to it? I'd say it was the perfect journey. You know, it was, in hindsight, it was perfect. When you're going through it, it certainly doesn't feel
yes.
like it. It feels anything, yes. anything but on time. But yeah.
Hindsight should be available earlier.
Oh, God, wouldn't it be nice?
Wouldn't that be great if you could see how it was going to be before it started? Yeah, make different choices. That was a really beautiful answer. And for your heart to be able to say that, because I feel like wherever we go, we leave a heart print. I feel like the heart vibrates and we're leaving energy wherever we go. And to leave energy behind that you make a difference and you help bring joy to people's lives. That's a really beautiful thing, Bill.
Oh, well, thank you. And likewise, you know, appreciate all you're doing.
Thank you. I think, you know, you can, when you walk on the sand and you see a footprint, you can clearly see where someone's been. And I live near the beach too. And they rake the sand with a tractor. I live near farms. So they rake the sand with a tractor every morning. And if you're the first person on the beach, you can see these singular footprints. It's a really beautiful thing. But often people can feel in a place where you've been that you've been. It's that, you know, that knowledge that love has been present and that you're leaving it behind. Because you wonder if energy just keeps on going. Do you believe energy just continues?
Oh, clearly. Clearly it does. You know, if you ever want a great experience, you know, some of the caves of some of the enlightened masters in, you know, in Tibet, Himalayas, you know, Potmitsun Baba, you know, I'm butchering the name, but if you can visit some of these places that people have those experiences, there, the availability for you to have a heart awakening by just physically being in the place they were, right?
Yes.
Right? That is a wonderful experience. Yeah. They say, you know, people talk about this, right? The energy of being in an old church.
Mm.
Why does that feel good?
Yes.
Well, the reason it feels good is everybody comes in and they're all on their best behavior and they're trying to connect with the divine.
Yes.
Thousands of people for hundreds of years are all trying to connect and be, you know, connected, right? So you're gonna walk in, it's gonna be a good vibe.
That's so true. One of the things I've done all my life is to go to empty churches and sing. And I've been kicked out of one or two, but I just love the expanse of singing in a building like a church. An empty building like that is just phenomenal. I love that. And I love to think that I've left some beautiful energy in there. When I go, I clear some and I take some in. It's a beautiful thing. Haven't done that for quite a while. I might find myself doing that in the near future. Oh, Bill, what a wonderful conversation that we've had today. And I'm wondering if there's something that you feel like you'd like to say that I haven't asked you.
Oh, gosh. I just so appreciate you having me on. If somebody was interested in Cognomovement, you can just go to the website, Cogno, like C-O-G-N-O, movement, and you can learn more about it there. it's available worldwide, and would love to have you join me on the journey.
Thank you. And I can highly recommend it from my personal experience this morning. I feel really glowing and I feel really present, and I'm really standing in gratitude for you this morning, Bill. Thank you.
It was an honor and a pleasure.
Okay, so when I finished, I think Bill's going to hang up because we switched. I'm not quite sure how this is going to go. But my name is Dr. Robyn Mills. I thank Bill McKenna for being my guest today. I hope that in some way your heart has been engaged or expanded by today's wisdom. And until we meet again, may your heart beat to the rhythm of humanity's heart.